Hello, I'm Dr. Mike. Today we're going to talk about feline lower urinary tract disease. This is a very common disease, especially in male or overweight cats. It is very important to recognize the signs of this disease, as it can be serious, requiring emergency care and possibly surgery.
FLUTD stands for feline lower urinary tract disease, and it's a disease that can affect our cat population, usually the younger cats who are anywhere between about 6 months to about 5 years or so. It is something where the kidneys are working and they're producing urine and making the urine go into the bladder, but the bladder is not able to evacuate itself. So the urine, it backs up into the urinary bladder and is not able to get out to the outside. And it's predominantly our male cats with this particular disease. Overweight cats tend to be more affected than our lean cats, but the young male cats are the ones who are most affected. Clinical signs that they'll often notice are cats who are going to the litter box more frequently than normal, so several times, not really producing any urine. A lot of times cats will also vomit and not want to eat. They will sometimes show signs of discomfort as well, just as the urine is accumulating within the bladder and unable to be passed. If an owner notices the clinical signs of this disease, it needs to be seen by a veterinarian immediately. It is life-threatening. Typical diagnostics that your veterinarian may recommend start with a urinalysis and a blood panel to evaluate kidney function as well. Knowing that the cats typically do not have a urinary tract infection associated with FLUTD, it's kind of up in the air as far as if they will recommend a urinary culture as well. Other tests that may be recommended include abdominal ultrasound. X-rays are important, however, for animals who are showing clinical signs for the first time, that's not always indicated. Treatments associated with this disease for cats that are having the mild symptoms often require a little bit of fluid therapy. So if you present to your veterinarian, they may recommend fluids underneath the skin. Sometimes they will prophylactically treat with antibiotics, but most importantly, it's pain control and monitoring your animal to make sure that they're not going to fully obstruct. Many times, dietary therapy is indicated as well, depending on what we see on the urinalysis. But the most important thing with dietary therapy is canned food, at least initially. If a cat obstructs completely, meaning that they're unable to pass any urine at all, the veterinarian will recommend most of the time to go ahead and place an IV catheter, sedate your cat, and actually place a urinary catheter to relieve the obstruction. Most of the time, it's not a stone where this is not a surgical procedure. It's a medical management situation where a few days on IV fluids and medical therapy, removing the catheter and then sending home for at-home care is usually what's indicated. There are preventative measures in as much as depending on the urinalysis results that your veterinarian will go over with you. Sometimes there are crystals that are there that require dietary therapy. Sometimes fluids are indicated. Sometimes other medications are indicated as well, depending on the individual case that presented for the feline urinary tract disease.
There you have it. Feline lower urinary tract disease can be a potentially fatal disease. I would like to reiterate a very important point that Dr. Mourning discussed. That is, make sure your pet drinks more water. To recap, canned food is a way of getting more water into your pet's diet. I often send my patients home on a very specific diet. I pick the diet based on results of their lab tests and their individual needs. Your veterinarian may discuss with you the importance of pH of the urine, if there are crystals, or if there is an infection present. There are many over-the-counter diets that claim to be urinary diets, and many of them can be very beneficial. However, you need to talk to your veterinarian first to see if they think a dietary change is necessary and which diet your pet should have. Remember, if you recognize any of the signs we discussed, call your veterinarian immediately. Don't wait. I hope this information has been helpful. Thank you for watching.